What's up, squad? We back at it again when they thought it was finna end. Yeah, y'all, I'm in the road, man. I ain't feeling too good, but I said the job must get done. My people's getting them a video today, no matter what. So let's ride, man. So boom, we still up. Hickey, I done made it to the unit. I'm up on the infamous Clinton Hall, moving around doing what we do. So now, about every 30 days, you'll probably get a fresh wave of intake inmates coming up for real to your unit. So boom. Today we get to load the inmates, probably about 9-10 dudes for real. We probably got 9 cells over. So boom, they come up. This when I meet my good man Rucker. Now Rucker was a system veteran. He had 3 older brothers that had already came through the system, from Baby Bookings to Cheltenham to Hickey. He had been everywhere. And I think Eastern Shore got a facility too. Shout out to my Eastern Shore people, my CA people, everybody that tapped in with V, man. Make sure y'all jump in the comments. Give me that 100 sign, man. I'm a little under the weather, but the job gonna get done whether I'm in the robe or not. So boom. So Rucker gets up there, and I never forget the first day he get there. I'm in my cell or whatever when they come up. So boom. About 4 or 5 in the morning, they pulls that old okie doke shit again. Boom, boom, they busting cells. Talking about, get up, we smell smoke. So I lie to y'all not. I'm going off. I'm like, come on, y'all on that bullshit. There's no way I got my cell raided the first time, my first night here for that shit, and y'all talking about this again. Come on, man. I'm starting to think they fucking with me. So boom, I get up, go through the, get on the wall, get stripped, coffee squad, all that nonsense. Boom, they gets to like the 8th cell. They bring Rucker out. Rucker got a little red Bic lighter, and he got the, I don't know if y'all ever seen the outside of the toilet paper, like the actual paper that the toilet paper come in. We use them, rip them off. You could use that as rolling paper, bibbity bip bip. So he got caught, Rucker and got knocked off. So he goes on isolation. Isolation is lockup for juveniles. It's not called lockup like when you in an adult system. It's called isolation. You in your room by yourself, you in your cell by yourself, and a staff will come check on you probably like every hour, make sure you ain't do nothing. You got that, and you got another type of watch. I don't know if I can say that on here, but y'all know if y'all know. So boom, Rucker back there doing this thing. They give him probably like 2 weeks on isolation. But during that 2 weeks, his big brother come on the unit. So now his brother going back there hollering at him. Everybody all riding his brother because they like, oh man, this big Rucker, he done been through such and such. I think he had just caught a charge. He got waved down from the jail because you can go, you can get locked up as a juvenile and they can feel as though the charge is too heinous and they can try to charge you as an adult. And if you do make it to the adult system, your lawyer can fight it to see if you can get waved back down as a juvenile to get some reasonable time. So it go both ways. So Rucker was coming back down from over the jail. He was already up the adult system. His lawyer got him waved back down. So now he got to do a long-term placement. Anytime you get waved down off of a wavering, you're going to placement. Anybody tell you different, they're lying. Trust me, I know. I done been there plenty of times. So boom, Rucker come to the back. So he doing his 1-2. He got the strips. He got the grass. He got everything he doing. So a dude tried to press him for real and asked him for a 20. So Rucker gave him the 20. He tell him, I'm going to have the bread for you tomorrow, whether it was in snacks, whatever it may be for real. So the next day come, every morning when we come out, you go about 3 in the morning, they gonna pop your cell, tell you come out, go brush your teeth and wash your face. It's called hygiene. You go do hygiene, then you come back in your cell, probably for like an hour and a half, lay down, then they gonna pop the doors for breakfast. When we come out from breakfast, go to breakfast, you come back on the unit, we do like round up group where do all of us sit in a circle in a chair. You go around, tell your goal for the day, how you trying to be positive, this, that, and the third. So boom, it's going around. So the dude that old Rucker is sitting right here. Rucker is sitting right next to him to the left of him. So the dude go, he say, yeah, you know, my name is such and such. My goal is to be positive today, stay out the way, have all good thoughts. You say stuff like that. So Rucker gets up. I lie to y'all not. Rucker say, yeah, my name Rucker, man. Only got one goal for the day. He grabs the chair. I told y'all it was like the big boing boing chairs. Man, Rucker grab that chair and pop shorty straight in the head. Boom! Man, I'm talking about he when he hit him in the head, you literally heard the boing. He get the wibbling, Rucker get him, mop, mop, he falls down. Now listen, this the kicker though. As Rucker get to beating him, little Rucker, cause behind him, he on isolation, but when we go to, they gotta feed you, you feel what I'm saying? So he gotta go to breakfast with us and he gotta come back and do morning group with us. So his brother is out at this time too. So as big Rucker beat the dude, little Rucker, his little brother get up, they get over there, get to beating him more, bung, bung. So we used to have these like, on every corner of the unit, you had these big black trash cans. So Rucker goes and grab the trash can, dump the trash can on him. Boom! So they beat him up. I never forget, we had the staff named Tobo. He was an African dude. Tobo getting there. He grabbing dudes up. Boom! We had Big West. West was a big, another brolic dude. He grabbing dudes, dumping them. Boom! Of course, put it online. We had to put it online. Now we gotta go back in the bag and lock back in. Now we ain't coming back out for the rest of the day until lunch and dinner. And if it ain't them two movements, we ain't coming out. So boom, they done fucked up morning group. That's one crazy incident, just like damn that fast. Now mind y'all, all this is happening in a very short time, so it's getting my mind ready of what I gotta go through, because I already know this is the first stop. Now mind y'all, Hickey, Babies, Cheltenham, the Eastern Shore facility, those is like holding detention centers, and then you go to what we call placement. Now when you go to placement, that's like a prison for juveniles. You know, you got the Victor Cullens, you got the Silver Oaks, you got out of state placements, you got, like, you can go to Tennessee, you can go to Ohio, you can go a lot of different places depending on your severity of your crime and then how much time they got you. You could be an in-state commitment, you can be an out-of-state commitment, meaning you might be 16 and you've been going to jail since 14, so you done already did the Backbone Mountains, the Savage Mountains, the Victor Cullens. So now you can't go to an in-state placement. They're going to literally put you on a plane. It's paid for by the state and all that, DJS. They're going to literally put you on a plane and send you to wherever they're sending you to. And I think like once a month or once every 2 months, something like that, they'll fly your parents out to come visit you because you still are juveniles. You get what I'm saying? That was crazy to me. So boom, I already know I'm going to placement. I got 12 to 18 long-term commitment. But I'm already telling them off the break, man. I'm refusing all out-of-state placements. So I'm trying really ride out at the detention center. I'm like, man, I ain't going to no Tennessee. You crazy. I ain't going to no Ohio. Again, man, deal with me. I ain't feeling too good. But we riding. So, boom. Now, I get a meeting from the placement that's coming to interview me for real. Because I ended up going to Silver Oak. We're going to go to that ride next. That's where we go to next. So, boom. I'm in there, I'm getting my interview. They asked me, you know, they got all my paperwork in front of them, my age, my name, my charge. Have I ever been to placement before? Have I ever been committed before? Am I an aggressive kid? Am I easily tempered, easily angered? Am I subtle? Am I cool, understanding? They try to get a grip of what kind of individual you are so they can place you in the right environment. You get what I'm saying? So boom, I get my interview. Silver Oak come. I tell them, yeah, I'm cool. Where y'all located at? He said, we about 2-3 hours away from here. I'm like, all right, I ain't tripping. That's cool. So, boom, I'm in once you get done your meeting, they take you out into the room, sit you down to the chair, handcuff you to the chair, while everybody else that's getting interviewed for that thing go in and out. So, we had to do Lil Mikey. Now, Lil Mikey, he going to go get his interview. So, I'm all out there. I'm handcuffed to the chair, laid back, chilling, waiting for the rest of the dudes to get interviewed so we can come and go. Man, you can hear Mike and the dude in there, you know, talking. So, the dude must have said, like, yeah, man, we not accepting you because we recommending you go to an out-of-state placement. So now Mikey, Lord Mikey, like, man, that's dead. I ain't going nowhere. Bop, 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 bop. He going off. So the interviewer must say something he don't like. Now, mind y'all, I'm sitting in a chair like this. The door is straight ahead and it's slightly cracked open. Like, it ain't closed all the way and it ain't all the way open. But you can still see, like, both people that's sitting right there talking. They side by side. Man, and mind you, you're not handcuffed in that room either. The dude must have said something little Mikey don't like. Man, Mike get up and get the beating him. Boom, boom, boom. Now, no disrespect. And this ain't funny, man. He was like an elderly white dude, man. So he get hit. He's like, oh, he fall back. Little Mikey just get the twerking him. Boom, boom, boom. Now, this the type, mind y'all, these the type juveniles we dealing with. This is why, in my head, I'm like, man, I ain't trusting none of these suckers. I'm not playing with none of these suckers. The first, verbal argument we get into, I ain't playing. I'm swinging first, I'm hitting first, I'm crushing first, whatever the case may be. So boom, they hear the white dude in there, oh, help, help. Lil Mike in there, shut up. He beating the burying them, rushing, wraps him up, boom, lock him up. Of course, needless to say, he definitely ended up going to Tennessee to go to placement. He definitely landed nowhere near in Maryland, Baltimore at all. So boom, they end up putting, of course, Lil Mikey on isolation. They ended up probably bumping his transfer up. If he, you know, once you get designated to a placement, it probably take about a month to 2 months to get all your paperwork right. And then they give you a date where they're going to come get you and you're going to be moved to the facility, man. If it took 2 months for you to get a bid, they came and got Lil Mike within 2 weeks. And he was gone to Tennessee, Ohio, man. Salute. We're going to keep taking this ride, man. Again, thank y'all for riding with me. I'm a little under the weather, but it's going to get done by any means, man. We're on that road to 2,000. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, jump in the comments. Give me that 100 sign. Team Stories with V. And like I said, man, we got to figure out what are we calling our membership, man. We got to name the squad again. Let's ride.